Researchers from the University of California, Berkeley, have developed a new deep learning technique that enables robots to learn motor tasks through trial and error using a process that more closely approximates the way humans learn, marking a major milestone in the field of artificial intelligence. They demonstrated their technique, a type of reinforcement learning, by having a robot complete various tasks. Putting a cloth hanger on a rack, assembling a toy plane, screwing a cap on a water bottle, and more, without pre-programmed details about its surroundings. The challenge of putting robots into real-life settings like homes or offices is that those environments are constantly changing. The robot must be able to perceive and adapt to its surroundings. There are various conventional approaches for helping a robot make its way through a 3D world. One such approach is pre-programming the robot to handle the vast range of possible scenarios. And another approach is creating simulated environments within which the robot operates. But these approaches are impractical. So now the UC Berkeley researchers turned to a new branch of artificial intelligence known as deep learning, which is loosely inspired by the neural circuitry of the human brain when it perceives and interacts with the world. In the world of artificial intelligence, deep learning programs create neural nets in which layers of artificial neurons process overlapping raw sensory data, whether it be sound waves or image pixels. This helps the robot recognize patterns and categorizes among the data it is receiving. People who use Siri on their iPhones, Google's speech-to-text program, or Google Street View might already have benefited from the significant advances deep learning has provided in speech and vision recognition. In the experiments, the UC Berkeley researchers worked with the Willow Carriage Personal Robot 2, that is PR2, which they nicknamed BRETT, B-R-E-T-T, that is Berkeley Robot for the elimination of tedious tasks. They presented BRETT with a series of motor tasks, such as placing blocks into matching openings or stacking Lego blocks. The algorithm controlling BRETT's learning included a reward function that provided a score based upon how well the robot was doing with the task. BRETT takes in the scene, including the position of its own arms and hands, as viewed by the camera. The algorithm provides real-time feedback via the score based upon the robot's movements. Movements that bring the robot closer to completing the task will score higher than those that do not. The score feeds back through the neural net, so the robot can learn which movements are better for the task at hand. This end-to-end training process underlies the robot's ability to learn on its own. As the PR2 moves its joints and manipulates objects, the algorithm calculates good values for the 92,000 parameters of the neural net it needs to learn. With this approach, when given the relevant coordinates for the beginning and end of the task, the PR2 could master a typical assignment in about 10 minutes. When the robot is not given the location for the objects in the scene and needs to learn vision and control together, the learning process takes about 3 hours.